Greetings to all, welcome to the channel Simtech05. This is the fourth video tutorial about the contact and interactions. In first video tutorial of the contact, I explained type of interactions, what algorithms for contact are available, and basically for those contact definition, we need the surface set or element set that I discussed briefly. In second video tutorial, I talked about bolted beam column assembly. That was just an example only. And in third video tutorial, that was very important. The first video tutorial is important, then third was very important. That is convergence error in the abacus. And I talked about their overclosure, why we getting overclosure problem, and how software make calculation for the contact, and what is the interference fit. And if you remember, the most important point at the end of video I discussed, that contact pair treat overclosure as a interference fit and general contact treat overclosure as a strain-free adjustment, or we can say simply adjustment. So we are going to continue on the same point, but in this video we will talk about only on the contact pair, not about the general contacts. See, in this particular problem I have two components. You can consider them plate and bolt. Those are not actually plate and bolt, but you can consider, okay. But by fault, there is some penetration between these two components. And whenever we have penetration, or we can say whenever we have overclosure problem, software need to treat those issues. And by default, contact pair treat those overclosure, those overlapping area as a interference bit. And that is problem for us. Yeah, of course, that is very good also when we require. But when we don't require this interference fit, and if we are getting such issue, then it may create a problem and we are getting a simple error. What is that error? Let me show you. Say here we have some number of simulations, and just click on the monitor and we will get this error. Too many attempts made for this increment. What it means? Software unable to converse the solution for the minimum defined value, and then it will be abort the solution, okay. But of course, for that we have number of remedies, and I will talk about those remedies in this video. So just dismiss it, and here we can see software treated overclosure as an interference fit, and we are getting huge number of stresses, value of stresses. And if I go for reduce the element size, again here we can see the stress value is increasing for the same problem, same overclosure issue. If I try to reduce the element size, the stress value increases, not even decreases. I will talk on that also. And in this case, in this particular case, the overclosure is removed, but generated stresses are very less, or we can say they are next to zero or equal to zero. So let me explain why we are getting such error too many a time, and how we can achieve this type of interference fit, and how we can achieve this type of strain free adjustment. There is approximate zero stress or zero strain. So just go for maximize this and go for exit the full screen. Okay, I am not going to waste the time in part modeling. I just going to tell you how the part look like. This is the 2D component. And we can see here, not only the 2D component, you can practice on 3D component also for the learning purpose. But here the 2D component will run very easily. That's why I considered here 2D component. So 2D deformable component. And the second component is my, again, the circular plate. But I considered this as a bolt. Okay. If I drag this, that will be my bolt actually. That's why I'm considering this component as a bolt. So then go for just here property. In the properties, here we have three materials. I'm going to remove this steel material, and let me show you this first material, that is the aluminium material. Click on edit. So clearly we have here only elastic property. Of course, there will be a concept of elastic and plastic material property. That also we will going to use in this video. If you are not aware about the material nonlinearity and how material nonlinearity affect the simulation, then I again suggest to go with my all four videos of the sequence linear and nonlinear analysis. So here we have linear material, and here this is my nonlinear material. So right now I am going to utilize the linear material only. I am not going to utilize this nonlinear material. So just go for property definition and make sure you are using here linear material. For the plate component also I am going to use here linear aluminium material. Then just go for assembly. Assembly is already done, and I want to show you, just go with the wireframe mode, and you can see here. So this is my bolt component and this is my plate component, and they are going to intersect each other, or we can say there is something, say, over closer. So after assembly you need to go with step. Of course, general static step we are going to define, general static step, and say increment. For safe side I am taking 500, but by default it is 100. You can consider 100 also. Minimum increment size is 1e⁻⁵. Initial I am suggesting to the software 0.1, and maximum I allowed up to 0.1. So just go for OK. I'm going to save this file in new folder, save as, just go for back and 2D plate video. Okay, so 2D plate. Okay, and after that I have to define interactions. Here we have to take care. I am going to delete this interactions and I will explain few things. Just go for here. Let me save the work directory also. This is my work directory. Okay. Contact property. In contact property already the tangential and normal behavior is defined. So very easily you can define. In future videos I will talk about those also. Okay. So this property I defined. Then I go for interaction. This is interaction property actually, and this is interaction. Click on create, and here it is asking for general contact and or surface to surface contact, or we can say contact pair. So as I mentioned in the start of video, I am going to talk about the contact pair or surface to surface contact in this video. So click on the contact pair, and now just go for define or select the surface. Just go for shaded mode. So let me select the surface. So this particular edge is nothing but surface of the outer plate component. Okay, so I am going to select this. Yes. Here you can see likewise. Okay, just click on done. Now again it is asking for the slave type. The slave type also I am going to define the surface, and this is my slave surface. The bolt outer surface is my slave surface. Click on done. You may worried why I am selecting edges as a surface. For that you have to understand the concept of the 2D geometry that is available in the abacus. Just click on done. Okay. Now simply selecting master and slave surfaces, then formulation is finite sliding, not small sliding. Okay, discretization method, surface to surface, and here there is no adjustment in the interactions. Just click on OK. Yeah, properties already selected that I created earlier. Likewise here, interaction property. Okay. Now just go for load. So what type of loading I want to define? I want to define only the one load that is at the outer of the plate component. So there is no displacement or no force actually. Just go for define that constraint. Ancaster you can define very easily, and now click on dismiss. At this stage we may think, if I am not going to apply any displacement or load, how the stresses will be generated in this particular assembly, as I mentioned in the start of the video. Just wait. So I am not going to define any force or displacement, only the constraint I defined. Then go for meshing. So mesh size you can take 5, 6, whatever you want. So by default we have here around mesh size of 6, I am taking as it is for bolt component or for plate component. Again go with the assembly, then click on job. So this is my job 1, and this job 1 I am going to delete my all existing jobs. Say this is the job 1, or I can say there is no adjustment in the contact element size 6 and linear material LM. Okay, click on continue, make sure parallelization, some number of cores, and click on OK, then click on submit. So what do you think? Will this simulation complete or will abort? Just think and reply. Let me click on monitor, and here you can see the simulation is completed. Now you may assume we have lots of interference between these two components, but still there is no single issue in the convergence. Software is able to solve the problem without any single convergence issue. Just go with dismiss and let me open the results. Okay, before opening this result, I want to close my all existing results. Okay, just go for visualization. So here we have few results, I am going to close those. Click on job and click on result. If you remember, at the beginning of the video I told you that contact pair or surface to surface contact treat any overcloser as a interference fit. So what will happen if I go for plot the stress contour? Okay, so you can see there is now no interference. Okay, this may look like the interference, but computational point of view there is no interference. Okay, here you can see, just go with the previous steps, or we can say first step. Okay, result may not visible clearly, just go for this options without result. We want to see the deformation and go with this options part instance. Okay, now we are able to see those two component very clearly. Here we are getting interference, and just click on the next step, we are solving the interference, or we can say software able to solve that overcloser issue. And how software solve this problem? Software assume that this inner component going to be fit, press fit within the outer component, or we can say this is our interference fit. And due to that phenomena, due to that forcefully fit the inside component into outside component, we are getting some stresses, and those are nothing but your stress result. And similarly, you can see the displacement, and here we have displacement result. Okay, so now you understood, even there is no displacement, no force, but due to the interference fit, software able to remove overcloser, and software generate some stresses, and those stresses are too much high. Now go with the little small element size, just go with the mass and go for part, and here element size 2, just go with mass. Similarly for the bolt component 2, okay, and go with mass. Yeah, assembly look pretty good, but still there is interference. I defined that interference manually because I wanted to show you the results, the differences. Go with here, create new job, or I'm going to copy the existing one and say element size is 2, and here this copy I'm going to remove, click on OK. I'm not going to overlap the existing result, otherwise we will not able to see those results for the future comparison. Just go with submit options and let again monitor. Again, there is no issue, simulation is completed without any single convergence issue, convergence problem. Just go with dismiss and result, and let compare the results. Just in viewport, click on that, create viewport, and adjust the viewports. I have here 6 viewports actually. I am going to close remainings. Again, go with the adjust. Okay. So here I have element 6 results. Yeah, and in this case I have results for the element size 2. Go with some standard view. Now go with the stress plot. So now we have huge difference in the stresses actually, and why this difference is, look, when I go for make any interference fit, or simply we can say shaft is tightly fitted into any hole. So what will happen, there will be some stress generated, and of course if we are going to use coarse meshing, the result will be less accurate, and if I mesh with the fine meshing, the result will be more accurate. That's why we are getting somewhat different result. Okay, so it is always recommended to use the fine meshing wherever we have stress concentration region, and this is my stress concentration region actually. Okay, this is the second thing. Now you may surprise if for the both cases result we are getting, problem is solved, then when we are getting such problem, the problem is arises, look, here we have stresses value in 1.9 e raised to the power 3 megapascal, or we can say 1932 megapascal, and here we have 2399 megapascal. That is huge stress actually, and this is my linear material. But in general conditions, we say when we have non-linear material, say this is my elastic plastic aluminium non-linear material, click on edit, and here we have plastic data. And for the plastic data, what is the issue, generally this plastic data limited up to certain value like 400, 500, or maybe for some material you have 800 or 1200, okay, up to that you have plastic data, but not more than that. If stresses will be generated beyond that, what will happen, fracture will be there in the material. Okay, but what linear material assumptions say, whatever number of stress will be generated, that is proportionally will be vary with respect to the strain, there is no limitations. But here in the elastic plastic material we have limitation, and the maximum stress value that I assigned, that is 484, and for the plastic strain value of this 0.14. Now click on OK, and I am going to consider this material for the both plate and shaft, whatever you want to say, shaft or bolt, whatever. Now just go for section manager, click on plate, and instead of linear material I am going to select the elastic plastic aluminium, or we can say non-linear material, and now again for the same, click on dismiss. Now just go with job, everything is same, only I change the material, and click on copy, and here we can say not linear material, LM is nothing but your linear material. I am saying here now we have non-linear material, and click on OK, and now click on submit, and simply think about what will happen. Will simulation converge or not? Of course there will be problem in the simulation, simulation will not converge, and why? Just before I answered that, yeah, you can see here the simulation is aborted due to too many attempts. So now you have to understand this, okay, software tried to attempt in the first increment, unable to attempt, then it reduced the increment up to this value, and we defined the minimum value up to this certain value, or up to 5 attempt I defined, maximum 5 attempt I allowed to the simulation, then software abort the simulation. Now you have to go with the again the results, here in the existing results, visualization, and just go with the first increment, or now right now we are in the 0th increment actually. When I click on the next increment, this first increment itself, we are solving all the interference issue. See, here we are getting interference in these elements, and when I click on that, in the first increment itself, we are solving the interference issue, or we can say overclosure issue. So what it means, software try to sort out the overclosure issue, or we can say software make them interference fit within the first increment itself. And if
within that first increment, huge stresses will be generated. Like here we are getting stresses 2300 and 99, around 2400. But our nonlinear data is available only for around 400 or 500 megapascal. So software unable to extrapolate those material data. Software will limit up to certain point, and then if software not able to converse the solution, not able to get the data for the material nonlinearity, then it will be simply abort the simulation. One more thing, it is not right way to say in property I can increase the material data randomly up to certain value, up to 3000 or 4000. No, it is not a right way. The right way is we have to remove this interference fit somehow. So of course, one way is the part modeling. You have to precisely model your component. If you precisely model your component and you're going to define the small element near the stress concentration zone, and very small overclosure or interference you will get, and software itself able to remove such a small issues. Okay, but by default, if you have some interference, like for the two component, for the bolt and shaft component, you have different element size and you are getting a little overclosure, then what you can do, you can use the second way. The first way is proper modeling and proper tolerance. You can define here proper tolerance between shaft and this particular plate component. Generally, we are not going to simulate the interference fit type of problem. We have some tolerance between these two components, this nut and bolt, and or we can say plate and bolt, or whatever component you have. So good modeling, good part modeling, and good massing is the first solution. The second solution is just go for here interactions, and go with here interaction manager and click on edit. And now we have one options here, adjustment of the slaves. So which one is our slave? This one is our slave, or we can say the bolt or shaft component is my slave component. This I want to adjust only to remove overclosure. Okay, if we have overclosure issue, I can say I want to remove that overclosure, and that's why I allow software to adjust without generating any stresses. Just click on OK, and now click on job. Even we have non-linear material, say I'm going to copy it. No adjustment. Instead of no adjustment, I have adjustment now. Adjustment, element size 2, non-linear material, and I'm removing this. Copy. Okay, now click on submit. Now click on monitor and let's see the results. Sometime if you have large interference or large overclosure, software may face problem for this options also, but here it's okay, software able to converse the solution. Just go for dismiss and click on results. The same problem, but slave nodes are adjusted even before the simulation. Okay, slave nodes are adjusted to remove the overclosure issue, and now we can see the stresses. Those stresses are approximate zero. Those are -13, so we can consider those stresses as a zero stress. Okay, even for the any of increment, likewise any of increment, the stresses are approximate zero. So this is the second way to remove the overclosure issue, and this is the strain free adjustment with contact pairs. By default, contact pair use overclosure as a interference fit. So at the end, I'm going to recommend to use proper modeling and proper massing, and in some cases you can use the adjustment options also. Not only this, apart from this, we have lots of options, 2-3 more options to remove such overclosure issues. May in future videos we will talk about those, but in next video I will talk about the general contact. By default, general contact use strain free adjustment, but if you want to use interference fit in general contact or with general contact, then also you can do. So to understand this video properly, I highly recommend to go with the previous three video of the interactions, and apart from these three video, you must go with the linear and non-linear analysis videos. Now these four videos and linear non-linear analysis videos, I will frequently use as a reference in the future interaction videos. So thank you for listening. If you have any doubt, you can comment me in the comment section. And if you want to join me on the WhatsApp, on the Facebook and Telegram especially, the link is available in description. You are most welcome to join. So thank you again.